welcome. This is new and old. Wanted to film today. This is just a nice sunny day here in the Pacific Northwest. See, the sun's out and very comfortable out here. And as you can see, here are the toys. Well, I guess not toys. This is the A86 Ford. I started it up the other day. It runs. It had a little bit of a fuel issue, though. The rear tank wasn't wanting to pump there for a while. But I clicked the switch back and forth, and now it runs fine. But, I don't know. And the Nissan truck, as you saw in my last video, we fixed that. It ended up being the O2 sensor was bad. So we fixed that, put new wheels and tires on it and stuff. But yeah, it ended up being the O2 sensor was bad. So it was sending the computer raw data when it kicked in, when it warmed up, and it was sending the computer raw data. So it was burning wrong. So yeah, it worked. I'm happy with that. RV is still just sitting there. We're gonna take it out here shortly this summer, and honestly I haven't done very much to it at all. I really haven't. It's just kind of just sitting here. I've been working. I started the new job and I just been working. I would like to repaint the front a black color, but I just haven't done it. I will eventually. I just haven't done it yet. So, but yeah, it'll look good once it's done. I would like to repaint it. I just haven't done it yet. But the reason why I started the filming today, because this is my latest video, is I actually have a new project. Well, not necessarily a new project, a new daily driver slash project. Let me tell you a little bit about this. Let's go into the garage here. I worked on it all day today, just detailing it, shampooing the carpeting, detailing. Right now I have the fan on. That's drying you can see it's drying. I pressure washed I pressure washed the mats, so I got those cleaned up. But this is what this car is. This car is a 1996 Lincoln Town Car. That's what it is. 1996 Lincoln Town Car. It's the Signature Series. So it's the lower end of the mall, but the backstory behind this car. I've been watching it. You can see it's cleaned up really nice. It's all cleaned up. Didn't always look like this. It was in pretty rough shape when I got it. You can see it's still got stains on the bottom down there. I couldn't get those stains out. I got it somewhat out, but I couldn't get them all out. And also, it's got a little bit of stains in the carpeting over there and on the side, if you can see it. That's got a little bit of stains right there. I don't know. I may take it into the detailer and see if they can get them out. I tried, but I couldn't. But it looks a lot. And, of course, the seats are a little stained. I'm going to have to get some stain fighter or some leather conditioner to do that. And also the rear was all stained. It still is, but I'll see if I can get the light on here. But it looks a lot better than what it did, but it's better than what it was. But it still is not perfect by any means, but it's better than what it was. Now, the backstory behind this. I got this Lincoln Town Car. I saw it on Craigslist. The guy was supposedly in Portland, Oregon. No, not the case. He was in Seaside, Oregon, about an hour and a half away. Was not too happy about that. But the car had 145,000 miles on it, which is really low for a Lincoln Town car in this year, in this vintage. This is the second gen. So I decided, okay, let's drive down there. Let's take the new truck. Let's drive down there and see what the car is. Well, when I got there, the car was in pretty sad shape. The guys I bought it from swore it was clean and spick and span, ran beautifully. It was in poor shape. It was muddy. It's still got mud right there on the corner. I still have to wash out. I still have to do some more work. I'm not quite finished with it yet. But it was in poor shape. I decided to give them $1,100 for it anyways. Why? Because of the mileage. 146,700 miles. Low mileage. These cars run forever. Well, I drove it home, ran fine. It was in pretty sorry shape though. I mean, it was stained, it had mud, it had mold, it was stained. I mean, it was in pretty sad shape. You gotta look past the shape of the car sometimes. So I gave him $1,100 for it, drove it home, took a chance. Said, okay, I'll take a chance. Well, I got it home, sat for a week, took it out, got it licensed and registered, saw that the belt was bad. Went to go look at the belt. Well, they neglected to put an idler pulley because the person who worked on this last broke the timing cover. So they jimmy-rigged it. And then they broke the radiator, jimmy-rigged that. So, $1,300 later in parts and labor, that was fixed. Alternator, the guy I bought it from put a used one on. Seems to work okay. We'll see on that one. I may end up changing that eventually. Spark plug wires are original. So, and it's also got a strap around the master cylinder. I don't know why. I'm just going to leave it alone. It seems to work. And it's got this redneck air intake system. I've got a new one. I'm going to put a new one on it. That does not stop here. I got the car home, had to get all this work done, spent $1,300, got it home, and it was filthy. I mean, it was filthy. I mean, it had dust, mud, dirt, I mean, everywhere, saturated. So what do? I take it down to the car dealer. They said $300. I said, not for an $1,100 car. I was not going to spend that quite yet. I still may eventually, but not quite yet. So, what do? I get home, and I detail it. I spent all day yesterday, all day today, with my carpet cleaner, and a little-known trick called 409. Traditional 409 with a good rag and a lot of scrubbing power. I had these carpeting soaked with 409 to get the stains out with carpet cleaner. And for the most part, I got them out. I mean, there was stains everywhere. I mean, I got everything out. I got everything out here. I mean, they can still see stains. I mean, you can still see stains on this side. I don't know what he had there. I don't know what that was. But he had still have stains in the carpeting there. I couldn't get that out. Maybe the detailer can if I decide to take it down to a AMD detailer. But it looks a lot better than what it did. A hell of a lot better than what it did. I mean, it's like a 99% done. And this side here, again, very bad. You can still see stains, but they're not horrible. They're not horrible at all. A lot better than what it was. So I shampooed the carpeting. Stuck an air freshener, redid the whole entire dash. Come to find out, it's got a core leak. It's got a radiator core leak. The heater core is leaking. So the guy I bought it from supposedly told me about it. He put stop leak. It fixed it for a while. That's going to be its next job. $983 to get this reader core out, because the whole entire dash has to come out. Would I do it on my own? I don't really want to mess with those airbags. In case I did something or set a light off, I don't have any means to do it. So I probably am just going to spend $1,000 and get the radiator core switched out. But the air conditioner works. Heater does work. Ventilation works. Yeah. It's... Oh, and this also right here, this door, the hinge on the door, on the bottom door, is bad. And the seatbelt doesn't like the latch. I have to use a screwdriver to push it out to latch it. So, and I also found out why detailing this car, it's had a paint job done. Someone's resprayed it. I don't know how well they've resprayed it, but somebody has resprayed it. And as you can see, I don't know. Well, we'll see. I don't know how well the respray job's going to work, because of course, you know, this respray job's the paint's coming out, and you know, we'll see how long this respray job works. It's been on here for a while, so who knows. So yeah, but it runs good. It runs extremely good. It drives good, and yes, this the air suspension has been converted over to coil springs. I did not do it. The guy who I owned it last redid it with new coil springs. So it does have a light that comes on that that will tell me that the air suspension's no good, but I don't really care. But again, we'll start it up here. Yeah, we'll just start it. Of course, no electronic key. This Lincoln Town Cars in this generation do not have electronic keys. Digital dash. And again, it just starts up, and there's the mileage. 145,775.6. And door ajar and trunk ajar. So yeah. That's why I saved it. It's got low mileage, 145,000 on it. So, that's why I saved it. And again, everything works. I mean, it sounds good. I mean, everything works. Nothing doesn't not work. I mean, it all works. So, we're gonna change this. We're going to change this and get I have a new intake I'm going to put on here, aftermarket one, that I'm going to do, make it look a little bit better. I haven't thrown a check engine light, so I don't, it seems to work. But yeah, so this is my car. As you can see, it runs great. There's no noises, there's no valve noises, there's no ticking. Not like with the Ford Explorer that had a lifter issue. It doesn't have anything. Anything just runs great. I mean, it's got low mileage. It runs great. Knock on wood. Well, I'll knock on some wood here. It continues to run great. But yeah, it has no problem. You know, everything works on this car, which is pretty dang good. Again, it's got 145,775 miles, and of course, it's got check air and suspension. That's because it's got coilovers in the back. The air suspension's is disabled. Washer fluid. That's a sensor in the washer fluid. I found one online. I'm going to have to replace it. Door ajar because I have the door open. Trunk ajar because I have the trunk open. So, yeah, it runs good. Radio works. AC works. Ventilation works. Everything works. It just works. And which is what I mean, cruise control. The cruise control works. Right here's the cruise control. Right here's the stereo and equipment with the temperature and fan speed and band and menu and all that. I mean, everything just works. Horn works. I mean, everything. Yeah, the windshield. That took a crack on the way home. That's going to have to be fixed. Again, that will be an insurance item. But yeah, everything just works. So anyways, this is my video on my Lincoln Town Car. I've always liked these second gen Lincoln Town Cars. I think these look traditional. I mean, the third gen's okay, but I like the second gen. You know, they made these until 97, and I just like the second gen. But, so yeah. Anyways, this is new and old. Thank you for watching. Like, subscribe, leave a comment. We'll see you on the next video. Take care.